Welcome to the Windows Club. If you encounter the error code 0x800f0922 from Microsoft Print to PDF, then either read through this article for the resolution or simply watch this video. I will guide you through the procedure. First of all, you need to disable and enable the Microsoft Print to PDF feature. All you need to do is search for Turn Windows features on or off in the Windows search bar and open this application. In this application window, scroll down to Microsoft Print to PDF, uncheck this box, click on OK. This will need a few seconds to save the settings. After this, you need to reboot your system and then you need to check this box again and then click on OK and reboot the system once again. The next solution will be to stop and restart the Print Spooler service. Press the Windows key and the R button together to open the Run window. In the Run window, type the command services.msc and hit Enter to open the Service Manager window. Scroll down to the Print Spooler service. Since the list is in alphabetical order, you simply need to find it accordingly. Right-click on the Print Spooler service and select Stop. It will need a few seconds to stop the service. After that, click on Start once again. The last solution will be through the Registry Editor. You need to remove a few registry keys and then they will be rebuilt by themselves. Press the Windows key and the R button together to open the Run window. In the Run window, type the command REGEDIT and hit Enter to open the Registry Editor window. In the Registry Editor window, go to HK Local Machine, System, Current Control Set, Control, Print, Environments, Windows, Drivers, Version 4. Right-click on this key, Microsoft Print to PDF and select Delete and then click on Delete once again. Then, copy the path mentioned here, which is a different one. Go to the Registry Editor window, select all of it and then delete this path completely. Paste the second path here and hit Enter. Then under printers, you'll find this Microsoft Print to PDF, right click on it and select delete and click on yes and reboot your system once again. Isn't this easy and interesting? If you have any doubts, please go to the original article on the Windows Club, scroll down to the comment section and write your query. We will surely answer to it. Do not forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching this video and have a nice day.